This is a demo of long context understanding, an experimental feature in our newest model, Gemini 1.5 Pro. We'll walk through some example prompts using the 3JS example code, which comes out to over 800,000 tokens. We extracted the code for all of the 3JS examples and put it together into this text file, which we brought into Google AI Studio over here. We asked the model to find three examples for learning about character animation. The model looked across hundreds of examples and picked out these three. One about blending skeletal animations, one about poses, and one about morph targets for facial animations, all good choices based on our prompt. In this test, the model took around 60 seconds to respond to each of these prompts, but keep in mind that latency times might be higher or lower, as this is an experimental feature we're optimizing. Next, we asked, what controls the animations on the Littlest Tokyo demo? As you can see here, the model was able to find that demo, and it explained that the animations are embedded within the GLTF model. Next, we wanted to see if it could customize this code for us, so we asked, show me some code to add a slider to control the speed of the animation. Use that kind of GUI the other demos have. This is what it looked like before on the original 3JS site. And here's the modified version. It's the same scene, but it added this little slider to speed up, slow down, or even stop the animation on the fly. It used this GUI library the other demos have, set a parameter called animation speed, and wired it up to the mixer in the scene. Like all generative models, responses aren't always perfect. There's actually not an init function in this demo like there is in most of the others. However, the code it gave us did exactly what we wanted. Next, we tried a multimodal input by giving it a screenshot of one of the demos. We didn't tell it anything about this screenshot and just asked where we could find the code for this demo, seen over here. As you can see, the model was able to look through the hundreds of demos and find the one that matched the image. Next, we asked the model to make a change to the scene, asking, how can I modify the code to make the terrain flatter? The model was able to zero in on one particular function called generateHeight and showed us the exact line to tweak. Below the code, it clearly explained how the change works. Over here, in the updated version, you can see that the terrain is indeed flatter, just like we asked. We tried one more code modification task using this 3D text demo over here. We asked, I'm looking at the text geometry demo and I want to make a few tweaks. How can I change the text to say goldfish and make the mesh materials look really shiny and metallic? You can see the model identified the correct demo and showed the precise lines in it that need to be tweaked. Further down, it explained these material properties, metalness and roughness, and how to change them to get a shiny effect. You can see that it definitely pulled off the task, and the text looks a lot shinier now. These are just a couple examples of what's possible with a context window of up to 1 million multimodal tokens in Gemini 1.5 Pro.